The first deployment option we're going to talk about for Azure SQL is SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machines, which is going to provide the promise of the cloud and allow you to have OS control. Now, there are many reasons why we see customers moving towards SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machine. They might be having hardware that has contract that's expiring. They might have SQL Server on 2008 or 2008 R2. They might be wanting to move to the cloud as fast as possible, but not wanting to make big application changes, or, you know, common times we see people are leveraging third-party applications that require access to that OS. Now, SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machine is going to be a great solution because it's really just SQL Server. So you can get the version of the SQL Server that you need, you can get the OS that you want, and you can also get all the features that are available in SQL Server. In addition, by moving to an Azure Virtual Machine, we're going to give you things like free extended security updates for SQL Server 2008. And we can allow you to set up things like automated backups and point-in-time restore. Now, a customer I really like to talk about related to this is Allscripts, because they were able to move over 600 on-prem VMs to Azure in a matter of weeks using Azure Site Recovery. And an interesting thing here is that they really took a phased approach. So after they moved to SQL Server and Azure Virtual Machine, they started evaluating some of their workloads for our PaaS service, Azure SQL Managed Instance. Now, in this series, we're not going to spend a ton of time on SQL Server on Azure Virtual Machines because it's really just SQL Server. However, there are a few considerations that we just wanted to touch on for you as you go through this process.
So in this series, as Anna mentioned, we're not going to go into all the depths of Azure Virtual Machine because the focus is going to be more on the differences and similarities between managed instance and database to your SQL Server environment. But there are some important points that you need to know because you are deploying SQL Server in the Azure infrastructure. So first of all, when you're going to deploy a virtual machine, just like you're used to doing something in, say, Hyper-V or VMware, you're deploying these things now in our data centers. So we're going to give you interfaces to do that. First of all, you're going to be able to deploy SQL Server through what we call the Azure Marketplace, which I've mentioned before, through the ecosystem, pre-installed versions of SQL Server, both on Windows and Linux, available to you. Or you can just install it yourself. You can install the OS through the Marketplace and then bring your media up, install SQL Server inside the VM environment in Azure. Now, Anna mentioned about Allscripts, so Azure Migrate's a great option because you can literally lift and shift the entire virtual machine VHD from both VMware or Hyper-V right into Azure and just start running away and operating with the virtual machine. Now, when you use the marketplace, we use something behind the scenes called the resource provider to register your virtual machine with us so you can take advantage of licensing and addition flexibility. You get things like automated backups and security updates because we know that you're running SQL Server in this Azure environment. And in fact, through that Azure portal, you can see all the different resources of your Azure virtual machines with SQL installed along with Azure SQL Database and Managed Instance. If you don't have SQL Server installed for the marketplace and you install it yourself, we do have a process for you to use the resource provider to register your SQL Server with us. Now, performance is an issue no matter where you go. And in your data center, when you're setting up SQL Server with virtual machines, you establish the performance parameters. You're using Azure now, we've got a lot of great options for you. You're gonna pick virtual machine sizes. And so we're gonna have things like memory or storage optimized sizes that you can choose from to pick different memory options, CPU options, and storage to give the maximum performance for SQL Server. Your database and your log, those concepts that you're used to doing, you're still gonna be storing those things on disks in Azure. And we have something called Premium Storage Managed Disks. They're gonna give you the best flexibility and the best performance for your workloads. In fact, we did some interesting stuff. We have free read caching from our Azure Blob Storage, which is really gonna maximize your performance, and you just have to use storage. You don't have to do any special option there. You do have to kind of configure Azure Storage that way, but it's not something extra you gotta pay for. It just comes with Azure Storage. TempDB is gonna be stored on a local drive with fast SSD storage. And if you need really low latency needs, we do have something called Ultra Disks that you can configure to put your transaction log or your database in those environments. Now, you're going to have to set up networking somehow, because remember, you're running your VMs inside the Azure ecosystem and infrastructure. That's okay. We have virtual network environments for you to integrate not only your virtual machine with other Azure resources, but even with your on-premises assets, could be your application, your tools, whatever you need to do. And Anna mentioned about some of the benefits of using the Azure infrastructure, even with VMs. We talked about automated backups and security. Well, you're going to hear more in this series about something called advanced data security. And in preview right now, you can even integrate advanced data security services in Azure to your virtual machine. Well, high availability has got to be important to you, of course. And normally you're used to configuring your SQL Server with things like failover instances, and even have backups of your databases and your VMs. Well, Azure, through the ecosystem, has built-in HA with their virtual machines, built-in DR using Azure Storage with multiple copies of your database files just by using Azure Storage. We integrate with services like Azure Backup. We support things like file snapshot backups. And you want to be able to do things like failover cluster instance and availability groups. We have that all set up for you so you can integrate those technologies within the Azure ecosystem. And for example, SQL Server on Linux has just come out the last few years. We will even integrate HADR solutions with Linux distributions like Red Hat to support things like fencing and Stoneth protocols. So we've got a wide range of solutions for you. Again, it's just SQL Server running in a VM. You're going to RDP in this thing, and it's just going to feel like a SQL Server in a VM. But you want to make sure that that VM is deployed, configured, set up for performance, set up for availability, using the Azure infrastructure, just like you might do in your data center. So virtual machines can be a great option. It could be your fastest option that you have to move to the cloud. And again, there are advantages of running SQL Server in Azure because of the infrastructure options we provide you. But just remember, in the end, this is the full range of SQL Server choices, the SQL Server additions, and SQL Server features that are running in Azure. Hope to see you in the next video.